Why don't you come up?
From a group called, you've probably heard of the Four Seasons.
Yes, indeed, and the LP
is called The Second Vault of Golden Hits. Remember the first one? You don't? Oh, I'll fiddly do. Remember the second one? Sherry, I've got you under my skin. Walk like a man. Big goat, don't cry. And Muddy, Muddy Moore. It's monkey time, and here's big, big news for all you monkey maniacs. The first issue of your own magazine, The Monkeys Monthly, is out now. Monkey's Monthly is packed full with news, features, facts, and photos of Baby, Mickey, Pete, and Mick. So ask your local newsagent for a copy of the Monkey's Monthly today. You've seen him on television, you've heard him on Radio London, now in living paper, the Monkey's Monthly. Three and a half minutes, someone will be down with the news. It will be Ed Stewart, Tony Blackburn, or Norman St. John.
Yeah.
Percy's the Snoopy or whatever.
Is that a dog in the gramophone record?
Shoots him down. I can't quite get the words. I don't know. Norman St. John with the news in just 40 seconds time. So we play a jingle, which should last for about 20, and then I'll gavel on a bit. Have an early news.
Wonderful Radio London. News around the clock.
Deadline Saturday, February the 4th, London. The Leader of the Opposition, Mr. Edward Heath, said this morning that the motor situation presented a sorry spectacle to the world. Mr. Heath urged the government to do two things straight away: to start negotiations again and to reface the defence cuts so that Malta and her people could have time to absorb the far-reaching changes involved. He was speaking to the Conservative Party workers in Kent. Peking. About 300 Chinese Red Guards were at Peking Airport this morning when the wives and children of some of the Soviet embassy staff left for Moscow. They marched up and down shouting abuse at the 40 women and children and carried red flags and portraits of Mao Zedong. Rome. Senator Robert Kennedy, who has been on tour of Europe, was received in audience by the Pope at the Vatican this morning. Afterwards, he said they had talked about Vietnam and reviewed the entire Southeast Asian situation in great detail. Cape Town. The American aircraft carrier Franklin D. Roosevelt, which has about 200 Negroes in her crew, docked at Cape Town this morning. Soon after arrival, the captain ordered that there would be no shore leave for officers and crew. A joint statement by the captain and the ambassador in South Africa said that this was because of the difficulty in organizing leave and it was impossible to accept the hospitality by the South Africans. London Airport. Britain's new High Commissioner for Malta left London Airport this morning to take up his post. He is Sir Geoffrey Torrey, aged 54. He said before leaving that he was delighted to be going to the island, but sorry that it was in such unhappy circumstances. And finally, Bournemouth. It was announced this morning that General Albert Osborne, who was the international leader of the Salvation Army for 8 years, has died at his home. He was aged 80. And the weather? This afternoon, most areas will be dry and sunny, but later on there'll be a few scattered showers. Temperatures this afternoon will reach a high of 11 centigrade, 52 degrees Fahrenheit. Tonight there'll be a fair amount of cloud and temperatures will drop to a low of minus 1 degree centigrade, 30 degrees Fahrenheit. The outlook continuing dry and mild. Next news on Radio London, and now this is Norman St. John reporting.
I do love you, you're the wonder for me. When I look into your eyes, I see my destiny. Peekaboo, what can I do? You're so fancy and free.
Yes, indeed. Peekaboo, number 6 in the charts. The new vaudeville band. Thank you, Norman. For the news. Half a minute early, but no. I hope it's a gorgeous day where you are. It's superb out here. Blue skies everywhere.
I saw you. I knew you were someone to dream with.
Thank heavens. Have you ever heard her speak? She's got the most fantastic Italian accented English that you've ever heard. Ah, she's sweet. She's only about 2 inches high, but she's 19, of course, which compensates for it, and she's lovely all over. And what a voice! My goodness me. Over to Bob Dylan now for a track from his album, Blonde on Blonde. The last track on the whole album, Just Like a Woman. By the way, if you get a chance, try and listen to Bob Dylan singing Mr. Jones.
Nobody feels any pain.
Thank you. from Blonde on Blonde, Bob Dylan.
And a thing called Roughly Calls, Just Like a Woman, done by Jonathan King and Dundee Dykstra. Also done by Manfred Mann. Remember the Manfred's version won over in the end. Oh, it's not fair, you know. 18 minutes until 3.
And now, through the auspices of Radio London, we present Strawberry Fields
at about 3 o'clock yesterday was I have been doing nothing but playing that record.
Ah!
And after about 500 plays, it still sounds
so fucking feeling.
Oh, it's lovely. And don't forget all you outdoor fans, you fresh air lovers, that the Camping and Outdoor Life exhibition is open now until next Saturday. So go along and see Radio London stand with Keith Skews plus Big L DJs and a host of stars. There are fabulous prizes to be won right there on the spot. Thousands of pounds worth. Try the Army ski slope under the supervision of a trained Army instructor. Try the angling competition and see the demonstration by world-famous angler David Carl Ford, how to catch a fish quick. And the Camping and Outdoor Life exhibition. It's open right at this moment, so do bottle loin. It's in Olympia. You know where Olympia is? And half a Duran. Just ask a policeman. Don't forget the Camping and Outdoor Life with the Holiday and Travel exhibition at the Empire Hall, Olympia. Now open until February 11th. Adults 3 and 6, children 2 and 6. And do come along and see us at Radio London stand. The excuse is there right at this moment. Just dying to play.
It's the number one record in the South
40 at the moment by the Rolling Stones.
Together backed by the beautiful Ruby Tuesday. Good record, that deserves to be number one. A position soon to be taken by old celebrity. People who've just decided to make up your minds to go to the Camping and Outdoor Life exhibition now on at Olympia will want this special information. Make sure you visit stand 160. Flint it in your brain. 160. It's on the first floor. You can see demonstrations of the versatile Bar Mix food mixer by J. Bruce Miller of Grimsby. Competitive. Prices are only 16. Hang on. 16.50. It's cheap. That's the price, folks. 13 guineas. That's not bad for a Bar Mix food mixer. It's terrific value. See it demonstrated at stand 160 on the first floor. The Bar Mix food mixer is only 13 guineas, so it's worth it.
TGIF.
Goodness, that's fun. Just gone 10 minutes to 3 o'clock. Now this beautiful thing with an old peculiar clock. Just peep outside your window, isn't it? Gorgeous weather. Blue from edge to edge. Lovely.